Good afternoon, everybody. It's another beautiful day in Las Vegas, Nevada. Thought I'd hop on, give you guys another video. I told you yesterday I was getting back to work. Well, here we are back to work, and the first thing I want to do is I want to jump right into something that I experience a lot, and I want to talk to people about it. And it's basically, I'm going to call the series Lessons, Lessons from a Blunt Circle or Lessons of a Blunt Circle. Basically, what I'm talking about is whenever you go to like a social setting or a function or something like that, and there's a bunch of people in a circle passing their joints, their pipes, their blunts, whatever it is, and you don't have any weed and you don't know any of these people, the proper way, or I shouldn't say the proper, because you never know what the proper way is. Who knows? You might be able to rob and punch somebody in the face. Hey, let me hit some weed. And they say, oh, great. Thanks, punch me in the face. Here, have some weed. You never know. But for the most part, there's a certain type of way you can approach the circle or approach somebody in a circle, and then there's ways you don't want to do it. And that's what I want to spend time doing a video version of now. For those of you that follow the blog over at GrowpHicial.com or DoneDoingDirt.com or any of the other affiliate links, you've already gotten a couple of lessons. Don't be shady. Don't be scared. All right? If you walk up on the blunt circle and you don't have weed and you don't have money and you just want it, hey, whose blunt is that? Whose pipe is that? Could I speak with them? I don't want to be rude. If you say, I'm not trying to be rude, or is there any way that I could please speak to someone about getting into the circle? Who do I speak to about that? You don't just walk up and try to like get next to somebody that's in a conversation and smile and go, oh, yeah, that sounds like great. And they're like, oh, yeah, pass that here. No, that's not how it works. You don't want to do that. You don't want to get involved in the circle and then invite other people into the circle. If you got into the circle, you don't just start inviting more people in the circle. Always get permission, whoever's running the circle, whoever circle it is. Because I go out all the time, and I'll fire one up, and I'll send it around. And I have no problem sharing it with the patients and people that, want to get medicated and whatnot. But there's nothing that pisses me off more than seeing the cloud go across. Because I got to admit, I'll watch that first exhale go. And you'll just see it. And people will just, ooh, I smell, ooh. And then it's almost like they look. And they see me over. And then it's like, where's the smoke coming? And then they see the smoke coming out of the circle. And then they instantly, you can see it in their face. They start instantly trying to move over and getting close to the circle. Faking the funk. Acting all happy and boisterous, especially like with girls too. Girls always try to use that tits and ass thing to do it. It's one of my favorites. I'll send people packing, I don't care. There's a right and a wrong way to do it. Now I'm going to do another video later that's going to talk about the bong rip I need to take. Let me take a bong real quick, it's been a while. I'm hitting this blue dream that Johny Blaze did a post about earlier, so. You couldn't see that, but, I packed the bowl, ripped it, hit it, knew to remove this. We'll talk about that later. Things we take for granted, but we'll talk about that later. But like I said, the blood circle issue. If you want to get into the circle, ask who it is. If you have to, just pay attention to who everybody is focusing on. That'll help you out a lot. But the worst thing, and the one thing I want to focus on, the one not to do, and this one's the funniest, and I'll use a story because it was hilarious when it happened. I had so many witnesses, it was just amazing. But I have to acknowledge my favorite part of the video, 420 mark. But anyway, I had a circle going, cannabis corner, blunt circle, patients hitting away, boom, boom, boom. Somebody rolls up into the circle after it passes and just kind of does the little nods their head, listens to the conversation, acting like they're in it, blood comes. And as it goes, I don't say anything, but I'm watching, I'm looking, he knows I've seen him. I've addressed him with my eyes twice and given him the chance to like introduce himself, say something, as if, hey, I'm leading this circle, looking at him like, and then when it gets to him, I said, hold on, my buddy, because he knew it was about to happen. hold on. I said, who are you? I said, do I know you? I said, are you a patient? And he just has this deer headlights look on his face like, oh, dude, you don't remember? Dude, that's messed up. He's like, we got together this one time when you were dying, you didn't have no butt, and you got a sack from me. Everybody in the circle just, this dumb motherfucker right here. Everybody knew right away he was full of shit, because for I don't buy sacks from no one. You see what I'm saying? Like, that was where he messed up. So that's what I want. Don't fake the funk. You can get into the circle. You can be a dweeby, nerdy nobody that doesn't have any weed but wants to get high because you got out of the house and you went to party and you see people with it that look like they have it and have the good and you want to experience it. You can. You just got to keep your head about you. Have some manners, common sense. All right, now I'm going to have more and more videos about this Lessons of a Blunt Circle, and I'm sure Johny Blaze, you know, my brother will chime in on them every now and then. But that's the main thing. There's a right and a wrong way to get in. Find out who's in charge. Ask. Communicate. The key to any problem in the world, you'll find, communicate. If communication's good, very few problems in the world cannot be overcome. That's the God's honest truth. I promise you, I've been through some bad stuff. Guns in the face, blah, 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 stealing all my stuff, lost family, wife, pets, blah, 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 blah. I've seen it all. But you'll survive. There's a right and a wrong way to do it, I promise. Worst case scenario, you roll up on it, hey, who's in charge? Fuck you, kid, get the fuck out of here. Great, man, I was just trying to be really cool. I just wanted to be able to hang out with the cool people, get medicated. Thanks. Sometimes it happens. Other times it doesn't. But I'll continue to get, because there's way many more lessons we're going to talk about on this one. But I'm also going to do another one here in a little bit. I'll wrap this one up. Happy to be back to work teaching and preaching. But I'm going to do another one. I need to clean this up. That's a whole other video. But things we take for granted. Because I saw something else the other night that I need to address. But we'll do that in this next video. All right, everybody. Glad to be back. Make sure you get over to dundoingdirt.com, growpHicial.com, mccnv.com. All of my old web presence has focused and been pointed to this new one. Make sure you check it out. Matter of fact, go check it out right now. Read all the blog posts. Read the other entries about Lessons of a Blunt Circle. I'm telling you, between myself and my brother, all the knowledge, all the experiences we have, there's some really good stuff coming in there. All right? Everybody, enjoy the rest of your day. I'll see you in a little bit with another video. All right. Peace.